Everyone knows DaVinci Resolve is great for color grading, but did you also know that it could be used as a super fast way to format videos for Instagram and Facebook? Today I'm going to show you how you can use the new Smart Reframe feature in DaVinci Resolve Studio 17, plus a few more tips to help you repurpose those old videos. Let's dive in. So what is Smart Reframe? Well, remember those old VHS tapes we'd check out from Blockbuster on Friday nights? They all started with this little green screen warning. It says, "This film has been modified from its original version." The point is, panning and scanning or reframing video content for new screens is nothing new. In fact, Adobe Premiere has had Auto Reframe and Final Cut Pro has had Smart Conform for a little while now. But the Smart Reframe, that's what they're calling it, in Resolve 17, it is new and it's pretty freaking awesome because it works great most of the time. So basically, Smart Reframe is a way to use the internal Neural Engine AI within the paid version of Resolve to automatically detect a face or action in the shot for new screen sizes. It'll move the position for you. And the reason you'd want to use it is to not have to do that work manually, which you still can do, but this can save a lot of time and could make you more money by being able to offer more deliverables on any video project. So let me show you how to use it and the best and quickest ways to get great video quality over to your phone to use for posting. We're over here in Resolve 17 in the cut page, and we can see I have a 1920 by 1080 timeline. The first few clips are DCI 4K, so they don't fill the full frame. They have black bars top and bottom, and then other clips right here do fill the full frame. And that's important because of a setting I'm about to show you. So you edit in the widescreen format, that's your main video. Then you're gonna go to duplicate it. We're gonna right click and say duplicate timeline. And we'll call this one our, instead of 16 by 9, we're going the opposite. We're going to go 9 by 16, and then we'll double click it to open it up. The reason we're in the cut page is because they have a nice little preset over here. If you click right in this section, we have an option for portrait. Choose portrait, and oh, it's the right vertical video that we need for our Instagram and social post, but it doesn't fill the full frame. So here is how you change that. You click up here again, you say custom timeline settings, and we're gonna be changing the mismatched resolution. Instead of saying scale entire image to fit, we're gonna be changing this to say scale full frame with crop, okay? Do that, and boom, everything fills up the frame, and we don't have those black bars. So everyone gets to make use of the whole image. Next up, we are gonna actually be going over here to the edit page to do our smart reframing. Just note, you can do it here in the cut page. It's right under here. I just like to do it in the edit page because it gives you a little more control over looking at the keyframes that we're working with. So why don't we start by just selecting the clips we wanna reframe. We'll choose these ones here from this harvest. We'll select those, we'll go to inspector. And then under the inspector, we have this new option called smart reframe and it's set to automatic. We'll click reframe. And it's using that Neural Engine AI that's built in right now to analyze them and try to find the best spots for the middle of the clip. And just like that, we saw it added keyframes to them. So we can go through here and check things. We can also make adjustments to them because they're just keyframes. The way you would make adjustments is actually super, super simple. So you can click on this little keyframe right here, and then this guy right here will expand it. And then if we zoom in on the timeline, Command plus to do that, and take a look, we can drop this thing down and say transform position X. And we can see these are all the keyframes that Resolve had automatically dropped on our timeline to try to make the best decision on what should be in the center of the frame for the panning and scanning. So, and if you look up here in the inspector, you can see under transform position, this thing is going crazy. So it's trying to maintain a specific position that it thought was great and whatnot. What if we want more control than that? What if we want to say, I want you to track this specific spot? We can actually do that with Smart Reframe. There's an option in here called Reference Point, and that's what I'm going to show you next. Now to show you how to use the Reference Point with Smart Reframe, we're going to go to another clip on the timeline, one that we haven't done with the automatic mode. We've got these clips right here. This guy's walking through the snow with a chainsaw, and we don't even see him here in this second shot. So why don't we say, we'll let the first one do it automatically. We'll just say auto reframe, and boom, look at that. It did a great job right off the bat. And like I said before, if you click these right here and then go in to say transform position X, if you wanted to, you can easily take these keyframes here and adjust them as you see fit, okay? We're not gonna do that because it did a good job, but we are going to the next one here and we're gonna choose object of interest. And instead of saying auto, we're gonna be using reference point. But to set it up so we can actually see where he is in the frame, because he's so far off the screen to the right, we're gonna first set it up so we can see him. So we're gonna go to position here on the transform controls. We're not setting a keyframe, we're just kind of moving him to the middle of the frame. We're gonna do that, and then we're gonna choose reference point right now, and choose this little object over here. This is this little drop down here gives us access to the, basically it's like a tracking box that goes on your viewer. So we'll choose smart reframe there, and there it goes. And we gotta just choose something of high contrast. It's kind of like any other tracker. So we've got lots of orange in this scene. It should do a decent job. We'll click this, then we'll say reframe. And just like that, it should have done a pretty damn good, excuse my French. It did a great job of centering him up in the frame. And we can take a look, and it's got the keyframes just like the others did down here on the timeline below. So of course, that's a great way to use Smart Reframe on new content that you're shooting, and you have all your clips that are all cut up, they're shot by shot, but what if it's an old video and you want to repurpose it? Or maybe it's a live cut from a weekend event. That's something I do on an every single week basis. I learned a little trick, and I'm gonna show you that next. I'm super excited about it. So next I want to show you, I have this Reebok spec spot that we had done a while back. I had done the color grade on it, and it's all one single video file. But what if I want to use this for social media? The first thing I want to do to use Smart Reframe is to cut it up into individual shots. This is using another feature that's in Resolve. If you select it and you go to Timeline, Detect Scene Cuts, click that guy right there. And this is automatically detecting when does the scene change from one to the next. So it's gonna show you all the different clips. And that way Smart Reframe can only be working on the individual shots at a time as far as how it keyframes those, rather than trying to keyframe between the shots, which would not give us the best results. Also, a little bonus tip here, if you wanted to go back and color grade it, you can see now we have controlled shot by shot of a single video clip. That's not what this video is about. I'm sure I'll have another one. But now that we have it all chopped up, let's get it sized for social media. Way we do that is we're gonna go to the spot here in the cut page. We'll duplicate our timeline, and I'm gonna do this one at 4x5. So those of you that do a lot of Instagram realize 4x5 ratio is like the perfect size to get the most screen real estate, so that you can stop someone's scroll as they're going through, because you're taking up the most of the screen that you can in the main feed. So 4x5 is right there. Now, Resolve does not have a preset for 4x5, so we're gonna be going over here and choosing custom timeline settings, and we'll choose 1080 by 1350 is the size that we wanna be doing this. So 1080 by 1350, and then just like before, we're gonna choose scale full frame with crop under the mismatched resolution. And now all of a sudden we have a perfectly formatted video for Instagram, except it's not smart reframed yet. So to smart reframe it, this time why don't we do this over here in the cut page so you can see that it works in both spots. So we can, over here, we'll just select all of our clips, which if you're new to the cut page, this top timeline is the same as the bottom. It's just, it's zoomed out all the way. We can click smart reframe and choose automatic and reframe, and it starts analyzing. So here's where the AI magic happens. So it's going through, it just finished up all 31 clips, and we can take a look and see how it did, either in here or over in the edit page. If you prefer that, you can see the inspector, and you know, it looks like it picked out a lot of the stuff that we wanted it to look at. Let's mute this, we don't need to hear the audio. I can hit scroll on the speed dial and just kind of shuttle through, and oh, here's a shot I know. He has a Reebok shirt on. If I zoom in here, this is not the frame, the section of frame I wanna see. So I'm gonna select this to reset it. And I'm gonna kinda, you can see right there in the center is actually the Reebok now. We're gonna choose, instead of object of interest, we'll choose reference point. So this is a time when you would wanna go in and do that. We'll put the little tracker right over his chest right there, the nipple Reebok location. We'll hit reframe, and then I just had that selected, so it kinda just locked on to the logo. So Reebok would be very happy that we had just done that for them. So those are all good, but how do we get it out of here? Next up, I'm gonna be showing you how to use the quick export, and actually how to make custom quick exports using the deliver page. Hold up, I want to take a real quick time out and say welcome if you're new here to this channel. I'm Chadwick. This is Creative Video Tips, which is all about helping you create videos that make a difference and stand out. If that's something you're into, please consider subscribing right down below right now if you haven't already done so, so you don't miss out on the new tip next week. Now let's keep cranking away because I have some great tricks that you probably haven't seen before to get those videos rendered and exported real fast with custom quick exports. So quick export is this little button here in the cut page, and it gives you all these little presets. There's H.264, which we're probably going to use most of the time. There's H.265, which is more compressed. There's ProRes, which is actually ProRes HQ. And then there's these social media ones, which are actually the H.264 preset here. So I wouldn't bother with those. They just have the ability that you can sign into your account to automatically upload. So that being said, quick export is not just here in the cut page. If you go to the edit page, it also exists, but there's no button for it. If you're working in the edit page and you're an edit page kind of person, you can go to file, quick export, it exists there. In fact, if you're just the colorist, not just the colorist, if you are the colorist, which is super important, you could go to file, quick export from there as well, and you get that same pop-up with those options. But there's only like three options here. What if I need more options and I wanna get stuff out quickly? That's what I'm gonna show you here. So if you go to the deliver page, you have the option to create your own custom quick export. And the way you create a custom quick export is by creating a preset first. So like I mentioned, the ProRes in the quick export is ProRes HQ. ProRes HQ is big file sizes. You probably don't need those for social media posts. So one thing you could do over here is create a custom preset for ProRes LT. So under custom, we can choose Apple QuickTime ProRes, ProRes LT. That's gonna give you a file size that's about half the size as HQ, but it's still gonna be, LT is still, it's around 100 megabits per second. It's a broadcast quality codec. Like that's better than what you would see on most television programs. And then under here is the one thing to take note of is the resolution. So we are at 1080 by 1350. So this is our 4:5 Instagram post ratio. When you create a custom preset, it's gonna lock in that resolution. So this is gonna be our 4:5 version. To save it, we're gonna go to these little three dots here and we'll say save as new preset and just name it what it is so you can find it later. So this is ProRes LT 4:5, for instance, okay? Maybe we wanna also do a ProRes LT for portrait or the straight up vertical videos. We would just go over here and change this to 1920. And the rest of the settings are gonna be the same, and we can say save as new preset, and we'll call this ProRes LT vertical, you know, or probably better than that would be to be more specific like we did before, 9:16. And now that we've done that, we can actually make those a quick export by clicking here, quick export, and we have the option to make little checkboxes for those. So now you can see that I have checkboxes by both of those. We can use those to export our video. So let's jump back to the cut page and kick this thing out. So this 4:5 video we had reframed, we just go to quick export. And now you'll see instead of just these six export settings, we actually have a sixth one over here, or I guess I can't count, that's seven. And under here we have our custom ones that we made. So this is a 4:5 sequence. So we'll choose ProRes LT 4:5, we'll click export. And it's as simple as saying, where do I want to send this? You hit save and it starts exporting. That's it. Like I said before, there's a little bit of a difference between making these custom ones, and that's regarding the resolution. So when you use a custom export, it's going to be sticking to whatever resolution you had set it to. For instance, if I go back to this other sequence that was 9:16 and I choose quick export and choose this 4:5 setting, it's actually gonna put bars on it because it doesn't, the aspect ratio is not matching that 1080 by 1920. So that's something to note, that your timeline that you set over here is, it needs to match what your export is, unless you use one of the built-in ones. So that's the advantage to using these built-in presets, is they automatically see what your timeline resolution is and they match it. So if I choose H.264 here, it's automatically saying, oh, this is 1080 by 1920. We click export, choose our spot, and it will also come out really nice and fast using quick export. So what's the best way to get it to our phone to post to Instagram without losing quality? Well, if you're on a Mac, the easiest thing to do is go over to your Finder. You can right click on it and say share Apple AirDrop, or it's AirDrop. And then as long as you're on the same Wi-Fi with your phone nearby, you can just choose your phone. There's my phone right there. And as we speak, it is getting blasted over, and just like that, it is on my phone. So it goes straight into the Photos app that's built into there, which you can then find easily in Instagram to post with. Now, if you're a Windows person, there's definitely options there as well. The one I'd probably recommend is everyone has Google accounts these days. Google Drive gives you 15 gigs of free storage. If you drag your file into Google Drive and then you can have the Drive app on your phone, that's another way you can get it on there. So you're not trying to text message or email. You know, sometimes these videos can be a little large to do that. You can just use Google Drive as well. Hopefully you found some great new tips you can use with the new Smart Reframe and Quick Export features. But if you're looking to dive even further into learning the ins and outs, no pun intended there, of editing with DaVinci Resolve, especially using the new Speed Editor, I have a great playlist popping up for you right now. It'll get you up to speed quickly. There's so much to learn, so I'll see you over in that next video.